The Indian coast has always welcomed visitors since time immemorial. The eastern seaboard, more so Tamil Nadu, has always welcomed visitors from China, Malaysia, Singapore, Burma and many other countries, and the food all along the coast was richly influenced by this interaction. The original inhabitants adopted the diverse influences and produced a stunning cuisine. So what we are doing today is three dishes from Tamil Nadu, a paisam or a traditional dessert made with green gram, a rich creamy chicken korma and a tomato rice. You with me, Marut Sikka, and let's start with the rice. I'm using long grain basmati. I always prefer to use this rice. It's my favorite rice. We need to soak this for about 15 to 20 minutes. We also need to soak some hara moong or green moong for our paisam. A paisam is actually a traditional dessert made for most weddings, but it's made with rice. We'll be making it with green gram. For our rich creamy chicken korma, which is made with coconut milk, we're using chicken breast. Nice, soft, succulent pieces. And this now needs to be marinated with some salt. Some red chilies. A little bit of turmeric and 1 cup of yogurt. Mix this well with your hands and then mix the chicken inside this. The yogurt actually tenderizes it and makes it cook a little faster. And while this marinates, you can take a large onion and slice it like this, fine, thin slices. We also need to make a paste with green chilies and onions. I'm using about 5 small green chilies, they're nice and sharp, and about 4 small onions. The onions need to be quartered and added to the green chilies. And to blend well, this will need a bit of water. So let's add that. And this is ready. You can never store fresh onion paste. It turns bitter. To store onion paste, either fry the onions or boil them. And now we need to dry roast and grind some spices. An equal amount of cumin and coriander. This is 2 tablespoons each. And this is done. Let's wait for it to cool down a little bit and then we need to grind it to a nice fine powder.